The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd Canto, 26th Chapter, Text Number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 13th, 1974, in Bombay, India.
Personality of Godhead, Kapila continued, My dear Mother, now I shall describe unto you the different categories of the Absolute Truth, knowing which any person can be released from the influence of the modes of material nature.
Atate samprokshami tatyanam lakshanam prithak yad viditya vimuccheta purusha prakitai gunai. This is the disease. This is called material disease. One is infected by the prakita guna. The prakita guna, guna means quality, modes. So, prakita means this material, prakriti, and spiritual means aprakita. There are different stages of knowledge. Pratyaksha, parokha, aparokha, adukhaja, aprakita. One has to go step by step. General knowledge means pratyaksha, whatever we perceive by the senses. That is called pratyaksha. And the knowledge which you receive from authorities, that is parokkha. Then aparokkha, realization. Then adhokkhaja. Adhokkhaja means knowledge which is beyond your perception. But there is source of knowledge, adhokkhaja. Therefore, God's another name is adhokkhaja. Adha means subduing, bringing under subjugation. Adha krita akhaja. Akhaja means the knowledge directly perceived by the senses. Akha means eyes, and akha means or to cure. So, any knowledge within the alphabets, ABCD, that is called akhaja. And the knowledge which is beyond that is called adhokhaja. And beyond the adhokhaja knowledge, there is aprakita. Aprakita knowledge. So, the prakita guna, so long we are in this material world, infected by the material qualities, satagun, rajagun, tamagun. That is prakita life, not aprakita. You have to go step by step. So, our Krishna consciousness movement is adhokhaja, far beyond this prakita knowledge, prakita guna. The highest position of prakita or material life is the standard of brahminical qualifications. But that is also prakita. That is not aprakita. That is also not the Brahma realization. Brahma janati iti brahmana. That is also the highest stage of prakita, glimpse of the light. But one has to become free from the prakita environment, prakita gunai. Our present position is we are infected by the prakita guna. Some of them are infected by the satogun, some of them are infected by the rajogun, some of them are infected by tamogun. So long one is infected by the tamogun and rajogun, his position is very abominable. Rajastama. One has to become at least on the satogun, the brahminical qualification. Then spiritual knowledge can be realized. Prakita guna. So, Kapildev proposes to his mother. Kapildev is Bhagavan. We have explained several times. Bhaga means opulence, and Van means one who possesses. So what is that opulence? Aishajya, richness. Aishajyasya samakrasya. One who is possessor, one who has in his possession all the wealth, we have several times explained this. Nobody can claim except Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Nobody can claim that all the wealth within this universe belongs to me. Nobody can say. But Krishna can say. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram Jagatavasam Sarvaloko Maheswaram. I am the proprietor of all the lokas, of all the planets. We become proprietor a few thousands of years, and there are so many difficulties. And he is the proprietor of the whole universe. That is also very little estimation, because Krishna says, Atva bahunaitena kingyatena tavarjuna vishtabhya aham idam krishnam ekangshena sthiti. Krishna says that by my one plenary portion I am possessing or controlling the innumerable universes. We have no information of one universe. Universe, that is also, we cannot estimate. But the innumerable universes are estimated to give us some glimpse of knowledge in the Brahma Sanghita.